Ma'am, language is not only learning different words for the same thing, but learning another way to think about things. A very hearty welcome to one and all present here. The day brings a lot of excitement as it heralds a day where students of Kulachi Hansraj Model School will exhibit their love towards English language. Today, students of classes 7th and 8th will be admiring and appreciating the distinctive work of Ruskin Bond, whose countless masterpieces have been loved, appreciated, and cherished by one and all. Let us all start the day by remembering the Almighty. I would like Chiranj and Satvik of class 8J to proceed with the program. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you all the entire people and my fellow the students of the
heartfelt gratitude to Ma'am Principal for giving us this wonderful opportunity of exhibiting our talent via this virtual platform. I would request Ma'am Principal to encourage all of us with her pearls of wisdom.
Good morning to all my dear lovely children and teachers, parents and everybody present here. Celebrating the huge achievement of entering Kulachi's penultimate year of 50th anniversary by organizing myriad events as well as an array of creative activities. Today marks the third day of Lingua Franca, English Week celebration. On day one, we witnessed a glowing tribute to the English romantic poet William Wordsworth by students of class 11th and 12th. On day two, students of class 9th and 10th apprised everyone about the English novelist Jane Austen. I can proudly say that it has been a wonderful experience to see our children's imagination and creativity getting unleashed on this virtual platform. Indeed, the purpose of collaborative learning is getting fulfilled fruitfully. Our students are setting a benchmark in this new era of online education. To all my students, I would say your fervent participation is integral in making the virtual program a success. I would also like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to the parents who have been immensely active in all the endeavors. The efforts of the teachers is also appreciable. Students of class 7th and 8th will play a tribute to India's most loved children's writer, Ruskin Bond, legendary writer from the hills. He is all set to mark 70 years of his literary career. If one loves to read, he believes nothing can really be distraction. The love for books comes from within. It develops over the years. It is a matter of pride for an Indian author to be known as Indian Wordsworth. Literary skills must be acquired from a young age. Written expression is an important aspect for shaping one's overall personality. Such events provide a wonderful platform to the students to not only showcase their talent, but also enhance their holistic development. I am truly looking forward to the creative presentation of the students that they would exhibit today. My good wishes to all the participants. Let us wholeheartedly embrace the new normal, appreciate the efforts of the students, and create indelible memories to be cherished for a lifetime. Thank you very much, my dear children.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Truly said by you. Such events indeed provide a wonderful platform to not only showcase talent, but also help in holistic development.
Indian language at the U.S. celebrated the 1st April, the day traditionally observed as both the birthday and date of death of William Shakespeare. The date is the result of a 2010 initiative by the Department of Global Communications, establishing language day for each of the six official languages.
Let us now witness the wonderful presentation presented by Vanshika Gupta of 7K.
With education, we can change the world. And English is a powerful weapon of it. So, a happy English day to all. But friends, do you know what is English Day? I will tell you. English Language Day seeks to entertain, inform, and increase the awareness of history, culture, and achievements of the English language. English is a Germanic language, which means its origin is from German language, and also it is the most widely spoken language in the world, earning the name of the Lingua Franca of the modern era. So interesting name.
This was indeed a mesmerizing presentation. Now let us head towards the performance done by Rashmi of 8E and Lavina of 8D.
Morning to one and all present here. Today, I, Rashmi Gandotra, and I, Lavina Gudi of Class 8, are going to present the interesting facts on language English before you. Fact 1. The English language has approximately 400 million native speakers throughout the world.
Fact number 2. English is the official language in 67 countries throughout the world.
Fact 3. English is a major business language. It is the official language of world's important institutions such as NATO, United States, and European Union.
Fact number 4. More English words begin with the letter S than any other alphabet.
Fact 5. E is the most commonly used letter in the English language.
Fact number 6. On average, thousands of words are added to the English Oxford Dictionary every year.
7. The word set has highest number of different definitions in dictionary. It has about 464 different definitions.
fact number 8. English is an official language of aviation. All the pilots must be able to communicate in English.
Hope you all have enjoyed listening these facts. Thank you.
Thank you so much for this amazing presentation. I am grateful to have such a delightful presentation.
Today, the students of Kulachi Hansraj Model School of Classes 7th and 8th are going to exhibit their love towards Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond, who is also known as Indian William Wordsworth, is indeed an accomplished novelist, a freelance writer, an editor, and of course, a storyteller. His books are a delight to read and are loved by one and all.
Let us all start by discussing about Ruskin Bond's life. Ruskin Bond was born on May 19, 1934 in Kasauli, Himachal Pradesh, India. Ruskin Bond was the son of Edith Clark and Aubrey Bond. When he was 8, his parents separated and his mother left him. Bond had a complicated relationship with his mother, who was rarely there to offer him affection. His father's undivided attention helped him grow. He felt loved and secure, but his tragic departure from his life left him lonely and broken. Following the sudden demise of his father, he moved to Dehradun.
Let us now be the spectators to Ruskin Bond's mesmerizing journey of writing. Ruskin Bond won several writing competitions, including the Haley Literature Prize and the Irwin Divinity Prize, during his school time. He started his long writing career at the age of 16. His first book was The Room on the Roof, which he wrote at the age of 17. He has completed his 70th year of his writing journey. In these 7 decades, he has written hundreds of stories for children and just as many for adults too, and is still continuing to do so.
Ruskin Bond's inspiration to write, it was friends and the time he spent in a rented room when he was in Dehradun. Ruskin Bond was deeply attached to Dehra, and most of his stories are inspired by the hills and valleys of this region. As we all know that Ruskin Bond is our role model. In his lifetime, he has written more than 100 children's story books. His stories always carry a message for the children. His words help to find our own words. His attention to minute details of everyday life encourages to make time for small pleasures.
A great book is a friend that never lets you down. You can return to it again and again, and the joy first derived from it will still be there. Let us now witness some of the famous works of Ruskin Bond. A Handful of Nuts, A Flight of Pigeons, Rusty, The Boy from the Hills, The Blue Umbrella, and The Room on the Roof.
Let us now see the efforts put in by Aradhya Goyal of 7G.
Greetings for the day. I'm Aradhya Goyal of class 7G. Let's celebrate the English Day by honoring Ruskin Bond. He is known as the Indian William Wordsworth. Here I present 12 facts about the great author Ruskin Bond. So let's get started. Fact number 1. Ruskin Bond was born on May 19, 1934 in Kasauli. His father chose the name Ruskin for him. Ruskin Bond was the closest to his father. He saw his parents getting divorced when he was only 4 years old. On the bottom, we can see the picture of Ruskin Bond when he was a child. fact number two, his father died of malaria in 1944 and Bond went to live with his grandmother in Dehradun, India. For the rest of his childhood, he was raised by his mother and stepfather. On the right, we can see the picture of Ruskin Bond's father. Fact number three, he wanted to be a tap dancer when he was young. On the right, we can see the book written by Ruskin Bond. Fact number four, he did most of his schooling from Bishop Cotton School, Shimla. Fact number five, he realized he wanted to live in India and be a writer in his 20s. Fact number six, some of Ruskin's stories, The Blue Umbrella and Sansana's Seven Husbands, have also been adopted to Bollywood films. The Hindi film Junoon is based on Bond's historic novella, A Flight of Pigeons. Fact number seven, his favorite and the first book he read in his childhood was Ali in the Wonderland and Other Tall Tales. Fact number eight, most of his works are influenced by life in the hill stations at the foothills of Himalayas, where he spent his childhood. Fact number nine, he has also revealed that he is very lazy and gets grumpy when it rains. Fact number 10, he believed that an author should be able to write anywhere. Fact number 11, he wrote his first short story at the age of 16. Fact number 12, he moved to Dehradun to be a writer when he was 30. Thank you.
Thank you so much for this marvelous performance.
Let us now watch a beautiful presentation by Nandini Singh of Seventh High.
Good morning to one and all. I'm Nandini Singh of Class 7th. Today, I will be speaking a few lines on the famous Indian author, Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond was born on May 19, 1934. He lived with his adopted family in Lahore, Mysore, India. The Indian Council for the Child Education has recognized his role in the growth of children's literature in India. Now, I am going to talk about the life and career of the famous Indian author Ruskin Bond. Life. Ruskin Bond was born to Edith Clark and Orbe Alexander Pond in Kasauli, Punjab State Agency, British India. His father taught English to the princesses of Jamnanagar Palace. Ruskin and his sister Ellen lived there till he was six. Later, Ruskin's father joined the Royal Air Force in 1939, and Ruskin, along with his mother and sister, went to live at his maternal house in Dehradun. Shortly after that, he was sent to a boarding school in Missouri. When Bond was 4 years old, his mother separated from his father and married a Punjabi Hindu Hari. His father arranged Ruskin to be brought where he was posted in New Delhi. He was very close to his father and often sees this time as the best time of his lifetime. Later, when Ruskin was 10 years old, his father died of malaria. Ruskin Bond was thoroughly heartbroken. He was told about this tragedy by his school teacher as he was in boarding school. Career. He worked for a few years freelancing from Delhi and Dehradun. He sustained himself financially by writing short stories and essays for newspapers and magazines. Later, he went to live in Missouri in 1963 because besides liking the place, it was close to the editors and publishers in Delhi. He edited a magazine for 4 years. In the 1980s, Penguin set up in India and approached him to write some books. He had returned Vagrants in the Valley to the Screen or The Room on the Roof. These two novels were published in one volume by Penguin India in 1993. The following year, a collection of his non-fiction writings, The Best of Ruskin Bond, was published by Penguin India. His supernatural interest led him to write popular titles such as Ghost Stories in the Rust, A Season of Ghosts, and A Face in the Dark, and many more hauntings. Since then, he has written over 500 short stories, essays, and novels, including The Blue Umbrella, Funny Side Up, A Flight of Pigeons, and more than 50 books of children. He has also published his autobiography, Scenes from a Writer's Life, describes his formative years growing up in Anglo-India, and a further autobiography, Lone Fox Dancing, was published in 2017. The Lamp is Lit is a collection of essays and episodes from his journal. Now, I'm going to talk about facts about the famous Indian author, Ruskin Bond. Fact number one. Bond saw his parents getting divorced when he was only 4 years old. His mother then married an Indian. His father died of malaria in 1944, and Bond went to live with his grandmother in Dehradun, India. For the rest of his childhood, he was raised by his mother and stepfather. Fact number two, he wanted to be a tap dancer when he was young. Fact number three, he did most of his schooling from the Bishop Cotton School in Shimla. Fact number four, his first novel, The Room on the Roof, was published when he was just 21 years old. Fact number five, some of Ruskin's stories like The Blue Umbrella and Susanna's Seven Husbands have also been adopted to Bollywood films. The Hindi film Junoon is based on the Bond's historic novel, A Flight of Pigeons. Fact number six, his favorite and the first book he read in his childhood was Alice in Wonderland and Other Tall Tales. Fact number seven, he is very quiet by nature and stays away from the attention of the media. Now, I'm going to tell you some awards won by Ruskin Bond. He won Padma Shri 1999, Padma Bhushan in 2014, and Sahitya Academy Award in 1992. His latest accolade is the Lifetime Achievement Award. Besides that, he has won several other awards in literature. He is popular among young adults. Now, we are going to talk about the famous works of Ruskin Bond. The Room on the Roof, Delhi is Not Far, Vagrants in the Valley, Flight of Pigeons, Cherry Tree, Aao Chalo Kurkure Khaye, The Blue Umbrella, The Road to the Bazaar, Our Trees Still Grow in Dehra, Panther's Move, and other stories. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Nandini, for sharing your thoughts. Let us all launch into the saga of pictorial joyride to Ruskin Bond's life journey. Thank you.
everyone, and welcome back to our special India Today segment on account of English Day. Today we have a legendary personality joining us. I proudly welcome the recipients of awards like Padma Shri and Padma Bhushan and the all-time favorite author of children, Mr. Ruskin Bond.
Thank you for this honor and a warm welcome.
We are delighted to have you. I would like to start this event with a few questions, if you don't mind.
Oh, I would love to answer your questions.
What inspired you so much at a very young age to write books?
I was an all-round in my school. Participated in debates, speeches, etc. Gradually, I discovered a true love for my books as their companions. That's when I felt motivated to write my own books.
Lovely. Would you like to give any suggestion to the young budding authors?
The young authors need to understand how to connect with the reader. The reader should be able to imagine himself at the character's place. Moreover, one should focus on the best part of the story. One should also focus where the spirit and sense of the story lies.
Truly inspiring. Do you have any specific message for the viewers watching our segment?
We should start reading books. In the ups and the downs of our life, books will stay as your best buddy and help you drift into another world. That is the world of imagination. Otherwise, everybody knows about the pros and the cons of the books. Choosing books is a preferably advantageous option.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable words. It's a pleasure to hear you. I hope the way you like books, you like surprises too, because here is a video message for you.
Hello, Ruskin. Hope you're good. So nice to see you on this TV show. I hope you at least remember me. It's your brother William Bond from Canada. I'm hearing about your achievements today, and this makes me feel so proud. I want to tell your viewers that Ruskin has always been a studious boy, and his friends called him all-rounder due to his active participation in almost every event. As many of you might know about our friends, they were not so close in our childhood, so I could never really talk to him about brotherhood like that. That's why it's getting a little difficult for me to speak with him today. But I hope that you have an amazing journey ahead, my brother. And thank you, India Today, for this opportunity. Bye, Ruskin.
Thank you, Mr. William Bond, for joining us all the way from Canada and spending your precious time with us.
Amazing presentation. Now it is time to enjoy the enactment of story Blue Umbrella by class 7C and 7J.
Today, the students of class 7C are here to enact one of the most famous book of Ruskin Bond, Blue Umbrella.
Charlie is going to act as Binya. Naisha is going to be Nandu. Ananya is going to enact as Leelavati and Rajaram. Pratishta is going to be Biju.
Neelu, don't go far. We'll return home after some time.
Binya, looking at the new umbrella falling from hills, gets fascinated. When it lands, she picks it up and started moving around with it.
Thank you. explore Nicky's.
It's a beautiful necklace. I want it. In return, you can keep my umbrella.
Binya takes the umbrella and gives her precious necklace. After dinner time.
Mom scolded me as I gave my lucky leopard's necklace for the umbrella.
Don't worry, I will get you a new one. Next day, we are running with the umbrella.
Hey Rajana, pass me the binoculars. Bring your hand, I hope I could get it.
But how will you do it? After some weeks,
did the color goes off, mister?
Next day.
I want this umbrella, else I'm not gonna have anything.
Leelavati makes a face of wanting it.
Next month at night, Nandu, looking at the photograph of umbrella, I'm making a wish to have it.
There is no point of regretting upon that umbrella. You cannot have it until you steal it.
Once I went to school and that too by mistake. There I learned only one thing. If you will steal anything, you will be cursed. And if we were stealing, we cannot steal as vigils here.
Oh, don't worry about that. We will be leaving for the wrestling competition the day after tomorrow.
Day after tomorrow.
Bye, Dinya. Take care.
Can you stay here for just one more day?
Sorry, Dinya. Bye-bye. Take care.
After some days.
Neelu, it's about to rain. Let's go.
Keeps her umbrella and goes to bring Neelu.
Binya, on her return, she could not find her umbrella. She started looking for it. After some unsuccessful trial, she cried and goes back home.
Next day,
her umbrella had arrived.
I have seen many hard times of life. I have seen the color of life.
Nandu, it's raining.
Oh no. Nandu, pinched. It was Binya's blue umbrella, dyed with red. Due to the rain, dyed washed off, and Binya bichus get angry by watching Binya's blue umbrella. Binya was only the one to be related.
Nandu, Rajana. You'll have to change your village. We'll not allow thieves to have shelter in our village.
A week later.
Can I have some biscuits, Nandu?
Nandu passing biscuits to Binya.
Here you go.
Binya leaves the blue umbrella intentionally, but Nandu thought she forgot it. Nandu panting.
It's not mine. You can have it.
The theme of the story is to keep others happy by doling out the things that you love most. It is tough to renounce the things that we love in the novel, The Lead.
Beyond the street. strange, especially when I come to. And I had a feeling that you'd be there soon. So I tried to rearrange all my emotions. But it seems the same no matter what I do. Blue umbrella rests upon my shoulder. Hide the pain while the rain makes up my mind. When my feet are wet from thinking this thing over. And it's been so long since I felt the warm sunshine. Just give me one good reason. And I promise I won't ask you anymore. Just give me one extra season. So I can figure out the other four.
Greetings to one and all present here. I am Manya Jaiswal from Class 7B. Monkey Trouble is our first chapter from our Class 7 English Literature book. Monkey Trouble is a wonderful story written by my favorite writer, Ruskin Bond. So today, I am going to narrate the story with the help of amazing sketches drawn by Shashank Bhushan from Class 7G.
Greetings to one and all present here. I am Manya Jaiswal of Class 7B. Today, I am going to take you to another beautiful world, the world of storytelling. I am sure that you have read Monkey Trouble written by Ruskin Bond. Today, I am going to narrate the story with the help of pictures. So today's session will be a great treat for all story lovers as I am going to treat you with my visual storytelling session. This story is about Tutu, a female monkey. Ruskin's grandfather bought Tutu from a street entertainer for 10 rupees. Grandfather was very fond of keeping unusual pets, which Ruskin, 8 to 9 years old, always encouraged. Though initially, Grandma was against keeping this unusual pet at home, but she accepted when she got to know that Tutu was a girl monkey. But Tutu was a troublesome monkey. Her mischiefs and wrong adventures not only caused problems at home, but also in the city. Ruskin's aunt named Ruby did not like Tutu at all. One day she surprised everyone by announcing about her engagement to Rocky Fernandez, a school teacher from Goa. The narrator was very fond of him, as Rocky always got chocolates and cashew nuts for Ruskin and even taught him marching songs. One day, Aunt Ruby and Rocky Fernandez decided to go to the bazaar to buy an engagement ring. Aunt Ruby made it clear that she did not want Ruskin to come along. Since Ruskin was very keen to go, he decided to follow them secretively. Tutu thought that submission was underway, so she also followed the narrator secretly to the bazaar. Ruskin was spotted by Rocky while they were in a jewelry shop. He asked him by waving at him to join them. Aunt Ruby did not seem very happy about it. While the jeweler and Aunt Ruby were sifting through the diamond rings, Tutu entered the shop, grabbed a pearl necklace, wore it around her neck, and ran out. Aunt Ruby, Rocky, narrator, all ran after Tutu, and so did the jeweler. Several bystanders also started chasing Tutu without even knowing the reason. Tutu leaped on the back of a passing scooterist, while the scooterist found himself in the arms of a fruit seller. From there, she made a landing on Washerman's donkey. Children on their way to school found this very interesting and started chasing Tutu. Tutu finally left the bazaar and took a road leading to the direction of the house. She knew she would be scolded badly and locked up at home for what she did. So she took off the necklace, threw it in the canal. The dweller, Rocky, narrator, and many other people, including the adults and children, also jumped in as if it was a treasure hunt. 20 minutes later, Rocky shouted that he found out the necklace and gave it back to the dweller. Finally, the ring was bought. Engagement was announced and a date was set for the wedding. One fine day, while grandmother was baking Aunt Ruby's wedding cake, Tutu was helping her in the kitchen, being as naughty as she always was. While grandmother was not looking, Tutu added red chili, bitter gourd seeds, and a generous helping of eggshells into the cake. Though nobody complained after eating the cake, but many people were not seen for several days after the wedding. Everyone thought that the cake had an interesting flavor. I'm sure that you have enjoyed my visual storytelling session. I want to thank Shashank Bhushan of Class 7G for making these wonderful sketches. Thank you.
Now let's get ready to hear a hearty conversation, which will be presented by Sarab Noor Singh, will be playing the role of interviewer, and Ahan Goel playing the role of Ruskin Bond.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Big Cook is a friend that never lets you down. You can return it again and again, and the joy for the ride from it will remain the same. So this was a poem written by you. So this is such a nice and a good thought. So that is good to know that you were just 17 years old. You wrote the first book, Room of the Room. And now the children are loving to read your books. You were just 17 years old. You wrote your first book. So how did your passion begin for writing?
In school after. I was fond of reading, so gradually it started and I wanted to emulate my favorite authors and become a writer. And by the time I left the school, I was writing and getting published to my first novel came out to be when I was 17.
That's great, sir. You are writing for quite a long time. So what do you think about the upcoming authors?
Even though there are so many novels in different generations of writing with fresh ideas, it's good to see that being serious about writing. Most of them will get established and some may not. So it's also a matter of chance that plays a part, and of course talent matters a lot.
That's wonderful, sir. See, in your most of novels that nature is a vital covered part of your writing. Why?
Yes. Nature is a topic which I write about tint, flora and fauna, especially up in the hills. Living in hills for so long has made me a part of my life, and thus it reflected in my writing.
Really? Dan, good to hear about. What do you say about the reading habit change because of the digital age?
I believe it's just the same. There are far many more people who are reading, particularly who are educated and can read. Their number has increased into the years.
Such a nice story. All the books you have written, which is your personal favorite, sir?
It's hard. Some of my short stories and your first novel can be your favorite sometimes.
What is your favorite genre to write about?
Although I have written a bit of novels and poetry, but perhaps I'm best in writing short stories.
Who are your favorite authors?
The great Rabindranath Tagore and Charles Dickens are my favorite authors.
That's nice. They are also one of my favorite authors. Any essays, poems, and essays you have written?
I've written more than 500 books, essays, and novels, and those are for children.
I often think, why would that be so simple? Is it a task?
Of course. People want literature to be difficult, and there are writers who like to make readers toil and sweet. They hope to take it more seriously than I have. I always try to achieve a prose that is conventional, and those who think that it's simple should try it for themselves.
That's wonderful, sir. Thank you, sir, for your precious time.
My pleasure.
So my friends, let us know more about Ruskin Bond with my presentation.
Now let's view the glorious presentation by Pradita Payaswani Arya from Class 7J.
Greetings to one and all present here. My name is Pradita Payaswani Arya. I am a proud Kulaji and I am a student of Class 7J. Let's celebrate the English Day by sharing pictures of my favorite lines from Ruskin Bond's books. Let's begin. Why I like Ruskin Bond? I like him because Ruskin Bond's words help me find my own words. His attention to minute details of everyday life encourages me to make time for small pleasures. To observe a wild flower growing in a creek and hear the chirping of a bird. In one of the books of Ruskin Bond, there is written that as long as grass grows on the face of the earth, there is hope for our planet. So my dear friends, always be positive. In another book of Ruskin Bond, there is written that you can be lonely in a crowd, in a big city, if you have no friends. There are some priceless things said by him when he told us that nature is our best home. Once you have lived with mountains for any length of time, you belong to them and must return again and again. From the book, Dust on the Mountains. When he showed us that the beauty of life lies in its changes, like the changing seasons. New colors, new music, new life. Seasons die and seasons are born again. The colors that are thrown are an expression of joy in the new springtime of life and young love. From the book, The Hidden Pool. Thank you, my dear friends. I hope you have a great day ahead.
Wow, it was indeed a marvelous performance. Poetry is a matter of life, not just a language. It's time to take a look at the wonderful performance by Kanika Goel from Class 7K.
Greetings to all. Do you know who is the most famous Indian author and is well known as Indian William Wordsworth? Yes, you're right. It's Ruskin Bond. So, on this auspicious day, I would like to recite a poem by Ruskin Bond, If a Mice Could Roll. If mice could roll, and elephants soar, and trees grow up in the sky, if tigers could dine on biscuits and wine, and the fattest of men could fly, if pebbles could sing, and bells never ring, and teachers were lost in the post, if tortoises could run, and losers be won, and bullies be buttered on toes, if the song brought the shine, and the gut grew a flood, this world would be better than most. Thank you.
Thank you, Kanika, for this wonderful performance. Now, it's time to view this great presentation by Vaishvi Tiwari from Class 7B.
Greetings to all.
Good morning, respected principal ma'am, headmistress ma'am, and dear teachers. Today, I wish the Diwali of class 7B, roll number 45, would like to recite a poem, Quiet Mind, by Ruskin Bond. Lord, give me a quiet mind that I might listen, a gentle tone of voice that I might comfort others, a sound and healthy body that I might share in the joy of walking and leaping and running and in a good sense of direction, so I might know just where I am going. Thank you.
It was a delightful performance.
Life isn't waiting for the storm to pass. It's learning to dance in the rain. This was a famous quote written by Ruskin Bond. Now, let us all have a look at some more famous quotes written by him.
Ruskin Bond, the man with the golden pen.
To be found somewhere between little and too much.
And when all the wars are over, a butterfly will still be beautiful.
On books and friends, I spend my money. For stones and bricks, I haven't any.
All glory comes from daring to begin.
Bad times are good times too. Prepare for better times.
Nothing is insignificant. Nothing is without consequence in this intricate web of life.
It is always the same with mountains. Once you have lived with them or any length of time, you belong to them. There is no escape.
By day, it does seem that our troubles won't cease, but at night, late at night, the world is at peace.
Don't be afraid of the dark, little one. The earth must rest when the day is done. The sun must be hard, but moonlight, never.
The world keeps on changing, but there is always something, somewhere, that remains the same.
Let no man take your dream away. It will sustain you to the end.
It's courage, not luck, that takes us through to the end of the road. A great book is a friend that never lets you down. You can return to it again and again, and the joy first derived from it will still be there.
Now, let us witness the creative work done by Pratham Sachdeva of class 7G.
Hello everyone. Today, I, Pratham Sachdeva of class 7G, will be sharing some of my favorite line written by Ruskin Bond. Hold on to your dreams and don't let go. Follow the rainbows and the tide in its flow. Tell you the suns at the break of the day. Find time for the flowers along the way. Follow the birds as they come and go. Hold on to your dreams and don't let go. Thank you.
Now, it is the time to reflect the words of wisdom by Samvida Saraswat of class 7G.
Greetings, Padari. My name is Samvida Saraswat. I am from class 7G. I want to share with you the words of wisdom by Mr. Ruskin. I am sure that I will follow these words of wisdom and choose my provision accordingly. Here I begin. We all have to do something in life. And if our profession, vocation,
our occupation gives us pleasure, well, that's happiness. So choose well, my friend, before you launch out on the journey of life. But make sure that the career or lifestyle that you have chosen is something that you really want to follow. Thank you, everyone. I hope you all follow these words of wisdom shared by Mr. Ruskin Bond.
Tribute to Ruskin Bond by showing the creative work done by the students of class 7th and class 8th.
Wonderful journey of Ruskin Bond, let's hear a message from the man himself.
Hi kids, hi fellow friends, young readers everywhere. Here I am sitting on my bed in my little room up in Missouri, next to the window from which I can look out and look at the mountains. If you've got mountains to gaze upon, well, you're not going to get bored, that's for sure. Because the clouds keep changing, the color of the mountain keeps changing. It's sometimes it's green now, because we're at the end of the monsoon, it'll be brown in another month, and then white when it's covered with snow. So lucky to be up here. And I know it's tough for so many of you cooped up in flats or houses in the plains and you can't get out as much as you'd like to, because I know when I was 13, 14, 15, I used to hike a lot. I'd love to get out. I'm a great walker. I'm not much of a walker now. But in a way, suits a person like me, because I'm fond of I still write a lot. I call in November. To look back on my life, friends, people I've known, and there's so much to write about. Well, I hope this will all be over for too long, because it really has gone on a little too long. But let's hope maybe around Christmas, New Year, we'll have a little more freedom to move around, explore, meet our friends, have parties, do the things that we've always wanted to do. So let's be well optimistic. I'm an optimistic fellow. So good luck.
On the behalf of all the students, Akriti wants to say something to our beloved writer, Ruskin Bond.
Greetings for the day, everyone. On this English day, I, Akriti Sharma, am going to show gratitude towards Ruskin Bond. I would like to thank one of our favorite writers of all times, Ruskin Bond, for introducing us to simple pleasures of life. Today, many of us still believe in magic, marsh, and mud because of him. He wrote his first book when he was just 17-year-old teenager, and that explains why our parents adore him as much as we do. He wrote a beautiful quote that the pleasure of travel is in the journey and not in reaching one's destination. In the end, I would like to say that Ruskin Bond is a writer who lived in the hills, felt inspired by its rarefied air, and exhaled stories that took shape in his heart. Once again, thank you, sir, for increasing our love towards books.
I would like to thank Ma'am Principal, who always encourages us in new endeavors.
Thank you, Mrs. Ma'am, and a special thanks to our supervisory in charge, Rashmi Kathuria Ma'am, and a heartfelt gratitude towards our English teachers and our dance teacher, Miss Aparna. Thank you all for joining me.
Dear children, it was a wonderful performance. It is rightly said that it's courage, not the luck, that takes us to the end of the road. Language is a way to express emotions, thoughts, and ideas. What we think, we can express in many ways, but one interesting way is through writing. My dear students, pen is precious. Children, all of you have done a wonderful job. It was a fantabulous performance by each one of you. I would say congratulations. And thank you to your parents for all the kind support. And the performance was so good, and it touched, I think, each heart. Thanks to all those who have witnessed the show live in the Google Meet and have watched through the live streaming. Thank you to all the English language teachers who have unconditionally worked day and night. I can see the spark in each one of you. You all are wonderful with full of energy. Thank you to all the teachers of other departments who have helped and contributed in their own way. I personally believe that every contribution counts. Thank you to Headmistress Ma'am, Mrs. Sindhwani, for witnessing the program, and all the in charges who have joined in for encouraging by students by their presence. Now, my dear friends, always remember, we belong to Kulachi Hansraj Model School, and our school, that is Kulachi Hansraj Model School, is an institution which grows with a vision and dynamic efforts of our worthy Principal Ma'am, Mrs. Sneh Verma. Thank you, Principal Ma'am, for everything you do. Your every little thing counts, and it gives us energy and enthusiasm to travel another mind. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Congratulations to all of you. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am, and thank you, ma'am.